I remember talking to Kobe at the Olympics. I said, yeah, y'all got a good team, but do y'all have a team that's going to play defense? Like, is your bench going to show up? And I was kind of wondering about how the bench was showing up. And of course, Clark is a fantastic surprise. He's playing extremely well. And I'm happy with the lineup that they're using. And people ask me this question all the time about what are you going to do when Paul Gasol gets back? I said, you need to call Manu Ginobili up. You just can't call James Harden up and take pictures, take notes from these guys, and come off the bench and use your talent. Well, out of Dwight, because you and Dwight just butt heads. And then people said, well, him and Knucklehead that's in Philly did it, but it wasn't the same. It's Dwight brings a totally different press.
Knucklehead in Philly, which one you said?
Knucklehead in Philly, the one with the afro. You know.
So. All that hair to an afro?
Yeah. But me and James talk about it all the time. It frustrates us so much to see a team with so much talent not have the record that we think they should have. So
it's been a trying year, you know, you have to give a little bit of benefit of the doubt, because when you think of, you know, Dan Tony's kind of had to have his training camp on the fly. You know, he didn't have a chance to really come in here and have a few weeks to, you know, look at combinations. So he's had to spend regular season kind of doing that. And I can see some signs that they're chipping away at getting the synergy that they need. You know, some of the things early in the season when they were losing some of the intangible departments. You know, while they're waiting for Steve Nash, while they're waiting to learn a new system, I thought that they could still hustle and have the passion and, you know, not get out rebounded and not get out hustle. So those were the things that I was a little bit concerned about. You know, Kobe, I would love to see Kobe get a cleaner shot. You know, sometimes I think it's very predictable when he comes across the half court and he's handling the ball. And, you know, he shoots that fadeaway three when there's other guys on the team that can hit shots. Steve Nash is over 50% shooter. He shoots 40% from the three. He's the best free throw shooter in the game. So, I don't, you know, Steve Blake can hit shots. So, but we want Kobe taking the shots. But that's the only criticism I have. And another thing, too, is on the ball, Kobe's one of the best defenders in the league on the ball. But then, you know, like I did this myself, sometimes I didn't see man and ball off the ball. You know, I've seen many games when, you know, Danny Green get a shot, Ginobili, you know, sneak behind Kobe. But, you know, those are some of the things I think if they can just touch up on those things, which they have against some teams that are like subpar 500. The test is yet to come. Tomorrow will be a big game, and then they can win, you know, two out of four games for the rest of the season. They'll be in the playoffs, and when that happens, when they get everybody back, there's not a team in the NBA that's going to want to see
it. By the way, isn't it nice not to have a producer in your ear telling you to wrap up?
Well, you
know, about 2 full minutes.
That's what they asked me to come here to do.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we want you to do.
Craziest thing.
I'm gonna get you all in here.
You said about Kobe playing defense on the weak side. Everybody here was like, yeah, you're right. And that's what I love. The Laker fans are basketball enthusiasts. They know the game, so I'm gonna applaud y'all because y'all knew exactly what we were talking about.
That's right. Jamal, you watch the games?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, what do you think?
Well, I think, you know, Kobe's got that syndrome where he's just been so good so long that, you know, it's so easy to criticize. It's kind of like when we play with Kareem, you know, it's like, big fella doesn't hustle, he doesn't get up and down the floor. But I think, as James said, it's been, you know, a lot of changes. Coach D'Antoni really didn't have a training camp. It's been on the fly. I mean, he was all drugged up when he got here. I don't know if the drugs are worn off yet.
He's like, he's back there. I'll wait till we see him in a few minutes.
But, you know, I think, and, you know, with all the changes, and I think, and all of us have been very successful in basketball, you know, with all the hype, I think these guys, you know, like you said, Robert Deere's a headline. I think they could believe what was happening, and they kind of let their guard down. But I agree with Phil Jackson. I think this team has what it takes, and I don't know if there's going to be enough time. I'm not saying they'll win a championship, but if they get rolling and make the playoffs, I would not want to play the Lakers.